Good morning, dear students. Till last lecture,
we have discussed about the fiber-to fabric, and today we will learn last point, that is the varieties of silk. Okay, see, in this lesson, fiber-to fabric, many points we discussed, how to get the wool, what is the process of wool, what is a silk, okay, life cycle of silk work, so many points we discussed before. This point is the last point in this lesson. Actually, this point it is not there in your textbook, but for more information, you should know about this. Okay, so what is the point? See here, the varieties of silk. See, now we know that commonly silk obtained from a mulberry plant. Okay, but there are the different types of silk. Then what is that types? Okay, so that we will learn today. See, a varieties of silk, what there are the different types of commercial importance obtained from a different species of silkworm. Now here see, the word is written, that is the commercial. We know that the silk is a very costly fiber, and because of that it is used in a more amount of a commercial purpose. Okay, so the different types of the silkworm, different types of moths, they are in a number of a different plants. Okay, so that we will learn here. Commercial importance obtained from a different species of silkworm, which is feed on number of food plants. See, now different types of silkworm feed on a number of food plants. Before that, we were knowing only the mulberry plant we use, because it is a most commonly used silk. So we were knowing about only the mulberry, but there are the different varieties of silks are there. Okay, so these all are there in a number of food plants. Number of food plants means different plants. Okay, now the next thing, except mulberry, other varieties of silk are generally termed as a non-mulberry silk. Means now mulberry silk, it is most commonly used silk. Okay, so we are knowing about only the mulberry silk, but other different varieties of silk, that all types are known as a non-mulberry silk. So see, there are two types of silk. First one is mulberry silk and another one is non-mulberry silk. Okay, so first we will learn what is a mulberry silk. See, the first one, mulberry silk, is most common among the many kinds of silk. It makes up 90% of the silk supply in the world. Means till now we were knowing about only the mulberry silk. Why? Because it is the most common. And see, 90% of supply, 90% of the silk supply in the world. So it is the most commonly used mulberry silk. Why? Because it is very soft, lustrous and elastic. Means this mulberry silk is most soft, lustrous and elastic. Now lustrous means shine. Okay, because of these characteristics, mostly the most common mulberry silk we are using. Now we will see the different varieties of silk. Means now we will learn about the non-mulberry silk. Okay, first you write this all the points in your chemistry notebook. Okay, we will next point we will see, that is the non-mulberry silk. Okay, now the next point that we will see, that is the varieties of silk in that non-mulberry silk. See, mulberry silk means mostly it is mostly common silk, and the 90% supply of the mulberry silk only. Okay, and it is feed on mulberry leaves. Now the next point, that is a non-mulberry silk. Now which are a non-mulberry silk means what? Those moth are not feed on a mulberry leaves. Okay, so first here see, iris silk, tassar silk and muga silk. These three types of silks are known as a non-mulberry silk. So now the first one we will see, that is the iris silk. Now what is the iris silk? Okay, see, iris silk reared on a castor oil plant leaves. Means what? These silk moth, means those produce the iris silk fiber. Okay, these silk moths are reared on a castor. See here, castor oil plant leaves. Okay, and it produces a white or brick red silk.
See, it produces mostly a white or brick red silk. Okay, then it is popularly known as a eerie silk. See, mulberry silk, it is feed on a mulberry leaves. Okay, and non-mulberry leaves, there are these three types. So first one we are discussing, that is a eerie silk. Those are producing eerie silk fiber. Those all the silk moths are there on a castor oil plant's leaves. Okay, this is very important. Remember this name. What is the name of that plant? Okay, castor oil plant leaves, and it produces a white or brick red silk. It is mostly popularly known as a eerie silk. Okay, now see the second varieties of silk, that is non mulberry silk. The second type is tassar silk. See, this is a second largest. See, second most produced behind the mulberry silk, means after the mulberry silk, the production of which silk is more? This tassar silk. It is the second most produced behind the mulberry silk. Okay, see, some picture is given here, how it look like. The means what is a tassar silk, one fiber picture I shown here, just to see this. Okay, now the next one, it is, that is a muga silk. Now next varieties of silk, that is muga silk. See, those are producing muga silk, that all the silk worms are feed on which leaves? See here, saum leaves. Which leaves? Saum leaves. And they produce a lustrous golden yellow muga silk. See, they are produced a different types of fiber also. Already the names are different. They feed on a different plant leaves, and they produce also different type of fiber. See, muga silk feed on the saum leaves. They produce a lustrous golden yellow muga silk. Means lustrous golden yellow fiber they produce. Okay, and only found in Assam. Okay, where it is found? Only found in Assam. Okay, and then they supply to all over the world. Okay, so these are some different varieties of fiber. See, remember the varieties of fiber. This is one extra point for you. Okay, means not silk we are getting only the one type of fiber. There are different, many different types of fiber. So in that, most popularly it is used, that is the mulberry silk. And mulberry silk, that silk moth on reared on mulberry leaves. Okay, now another type of silk, that is a non mulberry silk. And in this non mulberry silk, there are three types. First one is eerie silk, second one is tassar silk, and third one is muga silk. Okay, this eerie silk reared on a castor oil plant's leaves. This is very important. Okay, and they produce white or brick red silk fiber. Then second one is a tassar silk. It is the second most produced behind the mulberry silk, means after mulberry silk, which is the most commonly used silk, that is a tassar silk. And the third one is a muga silk. These silk moth feed on saum leaves, and they produce lustrous golden yellow muga silk, only found in Assam. Here is one chart is given for you, just to read all the information, and these all the points you write down in your chemistry notebook. And tomorrow's chemistry period, you have to solve worksheet which one I given you in birch. You just see, and tomorrow's chemistry period, you have to solve this. Thank you.